Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and fellow YouTubers. Thank you for clicking on the Starship Aesthetics review. And in this video, we are going to feature the Odyssey Tactical Cruiser. So we are going to go into the game right now and obtain this vessel from the Sea Store. First of all, I'm going to read just a little bit about this ship. And as you can see, the Odyssey Tactical Cruiser, I usually get all of my information from the online wiki page. And that's just right here, stogamemedia.com. And basically you can type in every kind of item or ship or weapon over here. And usually you get some kind of information out of it. So, the ship will cost about 250 Zen or 5,000 Zen if you want to obtain all three variants, because this ship is a variant of three, and what that means, there is a tactical variant, there is an operation variant, and there is a science variant. Both or all three ships feature the same bridge officer consoles or bridge officer seating layout, kind of different weapon power shields and auxiliary to, like, for instance, if you want to go with a tactical one, you're going to get plus 10 to weapons, plus 5 to shields, and plus 5 to auxiliary. And if you want to go to operation, that's more of a engineering type build, it's going to have plus 5 to all powers, meaning shields, weapon, engines, and auxiliary is going to have plus 5. And if you go for the science variant, you're going to have plus 10 to shields and plus 10 to auxiliary. So choose wisely, I should say. What kind of other information is useful? At tier 5, you're going to get 42,000 hit points, a shield modifier of 1.15, so that's really nice. Four weapons on the front, four weapons on the aft, and it has a crew complement of 2,500. Four device slots. The bridge officer stations I'm gonna address in the game, because that's, you know, more visually pleasing. Console layout, three tactical, four engineering, and three science. It has a turn rate of 6, and it has an impulse modifier of 0.15, inertia rating 20, and as I said, bonus powers are going to be plus 10 to weapons, plus 5 to shields, and plus 5 to auxiliary. Now, this vessel also comes equipped with an Aquarius Escort. An Aquarius Escort is just a console that's going to give you a pet that is going to follow you around, and it's going to attack your target. So that's really nice. And this ship also has an ability, Advanced Quantum Slipstream Drive. Very useful if you're transitioning from one system to another system, you know, really, really nice. It also has strategic maneuvering, shield frequency modulation, weapon system efficiency, and attract fire. Now, in the game, I am going to obtain this one from the Zen store, because I already bought the entire pack. And I need to scroll down a little bit. And as you can see, I've bought some time ago the Odyssey bundle, and I'm going to claim the tactical cruiser, because that's a tactical variant where this video is going to be about. So, unpacking that one, and it gives me the Vistula. All right, some weird name, but okay. Now I'm gonna go to the NPC right there where you can select this vessel and going to be the ship that we are going to fly. Where is it? Right here. Now this vessel is the normal tier 5, and if you want to upgrade it, you're going to get tier 5 view, and the base hull is going to increase at level 60. It's going to be 56,000 hit points, and you're going to get an additional tactical console. So basically you're going to have 4 engineering, 4 tactical, and 3 science consoles slots. You're also going to get a mastery package. Level 1 is going to give you absorption hull plating, plus 25 physical damage resistant, plus 25 kinetic damage resistant. Really, really nice, really tank abilities on this ship. Rapid repairs, it is going to regenerate 7.1 hull or 1.25 of your current maximum every 3 seconds in space. Twice this amount is regenerated out of combat. Level 3 is going to give you an enhanced hull plating. Plus 25 all damage resistant rating and plus 25 radiation damage resistant rating. And level 4 is going to give you armored hull 10%, plus 10% hull hit points. So that is really, really nice. This ship is going to be a tank for everyone that has not obtained this vessel and is looking for a tank ship. This one is really, really, really recommended. Now, as I said, 4 weapons on the front, 4 weapons on the aft, 1 deflector, impulse, warp core, and normal shield. 4 device slots, the console layout we already talked about. So I'm going to ready this starship, and I'm going to name it the Vis. Alrighty. So what we're going to do right now, we're going to show you a little bit a modification, if you can, to customize your starship right here. And I'm going to show you what kind of customization can be done to this ship. There is also an interior that I'm going to show. It's really, really nice. I'm liking that variant really much. And I should point it downwards so you guys can see the windows a little bit better. And the modification that there is, this is the normal one, type 1, type 2, type 3, and my favorite, type 4, makes this vessel a little bit scary looking. There are also different type of materials that you can select for your hull. And I'm just going to go with type 4. Because that's really my personal preferences, as they say. There are a little bit of customization that you can do on these big lines over here. Let me just, can I zoom in over here? Zoom. No, I can't. Sorry about that. Maybe you guys can see it over here. On this part right here on the bow, you can see some kind of different colors changes that you can do. Well, not a lot of customization can be done to this ship, unfortunately. In the later stage of STO or Cryptic or Star Trek Online, whatever you want to call it, there was an option to especially the latest ships, you can basically change the hull, the nacelles, the pylons, and basically whatever kind of option that you wanted to do, you could change. But this ship is like, I don't know, it's like a year old, so doesn't really offer any different in customization the way you want it to be. It's basically that, and you can't actually change it any more than that. So yeah, okay, so we're going to purchase this one, and yes, that's going to be our ship. Now, just a little bit of information. As you guys could see, I've kind of went down my engineering credits, or energy credits, not engineering credits. My energy credits went down when I bought the strike ship. But fortunately, I obtained one through the research and development package. So I got, basically, I had two of them. And I put one on the exchange for that amount, and this guy bought him. So if you know that guy, tell him with a big thank you, because he kind of, like, you know, gave me my energy credit back. So that's really, really nice of him. Just a little bit of a detour. Sorry if I'm wasting your time right now. And right now we're going to in space, because in space, that is where all the action happens. And in space, I'm going to show you guys the different visualization with which this ship has to offer. And when we're done with that, I'm going to show you the bridge that is really, really awesome on this ship. And I wish that they put out some more bridge packs just like that, because I think everybody is liking this ship. So we're just moving a little bit away from all of the leg areas where people, like, warp in and warp out. We do not want that in the video, so we're just gonna move a little bit away from that. And that's far enough right here. So let's see, the statistics is going to vary for player to player, so I'm not going to talk a lot about that. The skill tree as well, specialization traits. The bridge officer seatings. You have a lieutenant commander universal station, so you basically can put in everybody that you want there, but I really want one that has gravity well, especially in infected space. You kind of need a guy that does crowd control, so that's really nice. Really nice ability to have. Let's see what else. Radiation dot. Let me put you over there. Oops, that's not good. You can be there and charge particle burst. Tractor beam repulsor is good. What else? What else? Do we have tactical team? We do not have tactical team. So this is the way I'm going to fly this ship, just for the review. I'm going to have gravity well one, so you know, you can have a little bit of crowd control, a little bit of hull healing, shield healing, fire at will, beta, tractor beam repulsor, a little bit of shielding, you know, basically a little bit of emergency power to auxiliary, just a little bit of hull healing and tactical team. Really nice to do. So bridge officer seating, that is what I was talking about. Lieutenant commander universal station, so you can basically put anything over there. An ensign universal station, so you can put in both of these seats. You can put a tactical, an engineering, or a science character. It's up to you. And then you have two lieutenant tactical station, or one lieutenant tactical station and one lieutenant science station. So you can put, you know, tactical and science abilities over there. And at this seating right here, there is a lieutenant. It's called the commander engineering station. So you can put, like, you know, engineering abilities over there. What else? Not a lot. So we're going to get to the fun part, and the fun part is going to be slotting all of the different space sets right here. And I'm going to start off with the adaptive M.A.C.O. And this is how this ship looks like with the adaptive M.A.C.O. space set equipped it on this ship. Look at that glow on top of the hull. Now, a couple of you guys, a couple of guys on YouTube have been asking, what are those flares, lights coming out of the engine? That is just a buff that I have. So basically, that's not part of any ship. That's just a character buff or a captain buff, I should say. So this is the way it looks with the adaptive M.A.C.O. This ship does turn a little bit on the slow side, but you know, it's kind of worth it. It is a cruiser after all, so the Aegis space set is next. One, two, three, there it is. That is the Aegis space set. Equipped it on this ship. And I'm just gonna zoom in a little bit here so you guys can see the finer details. Maybe that's just too much. There it is. That's better. So you guys can see a little bit of the background. Some really nice finer details here and there with the Aegis space set. So next base set is going to be the Borg set, and that's the Borg shields. There we go. And this is how it looks with the Borg space set. Really, really nice details. That big deflector dish from the Borg right on top of the deflector. Really nice. I'm liking it. What else? The counter command space set. There we go, 1, 2, 3 set. And this is how it looks with the counter command space set, with a nice engine wake from the counter command engines. That awesome deflector animation over there, and the really nice pattern on the hull from the shield space set. And in the game, I'm also going to show you the Aquarius pet that comes out of this area of the ship. It's kind of like the butt size. It goes away. And it also docks in here. So it's really nice to for you guys to see that. If you haven't seen that one, maybe I can show you guys right here what I'm talking about. Keep your eye on this part right here. There goes. That's the pet. It's basically just one pet that you can have. You know, so it's going to follow you around. Oh, the next space set is going to be the Delta space set. Two, three set. There it is. There is the Delta space set. And you can see now there is like this big gap over here that's like missing. And that's just, you know, the space set. No, not the space set. That's like the place where the pet kind of needs to dock. So anyway, detour. Delta Space set. It's kind of, you know, grayish color. Brownish, dark brownish color. This is how it looks. But the statistics of the Delta Space set is really, really nice. If you guys are looking for a space set and you don't know what to choose, go with the Delta Space set because it's really nice. It's one of the latest versions of space sets, so it's, you know, kind of all in, you know, everything that you need. Not specific to science or tactical or engineering type. You can't go wrong with a Delta Space set. That's what I'm talking about right now. Let's see. The Dyson Space set. And you guys are in for a treat right now. Because this ship is going to turn whitish. There it is. Really nice. And as it transitions from the shadow side of the sun, the ship also changes in color. Right here. Look at that, it's gonna change to white. And I don't know if a lot of people out there have seen this, but this is a nice feature from the Dyson space set. And on top of the ship as well. And when it transitions back up, you're gonna see those lines like that. Really nice. Just like that, you see all of those finer details that Cryptic has done with this space set. Really, really, really nice. Let's see. The Jem'Hadar space set is going to turn this ship pinkish in color. There it is. With pink lines everywhere, including the engine wake and the nacelles as well, including the deflector dish. And I'm sorry, I'm kind of having a little bit of a lag issue with Cryptic. It is Friday after all, so a lot of people playing Star Trek online, and that's actually a good thing. I mean, you know, we can support the community if the way we can. It's always a good thing. And that is that Aquarius pet that this tactical variant has to offer. So the Borg space set next is going to be the Kobali space set. No, that's the wrong one. The Kobali space set. The Kobali space set doesn't offer any different in visualization wise to the ship's hull and all that. So this is just the basic ship that we just customize at the NPC. And if you guys see any difference, please correct me on the section below where you can write your comment on YouTube. Because I really like to hear from you guys. If I'm making any mistakes, feel free to shout it out. The M.A.C.O. space set is going to be next. Now, the M.A.C.O. is the same visualization as the adaptive M.A.C.O. Some people say that there are differences, but I haven't seen any of them. And as you guys just saw, some kind of animation where the ship, the Aquarius pet, kind of docked. I think that's a bug because it didn't dock, as you guys can see. But I don't know, maybe there's like a a timer that goes off, and when your ship is like, you know, doing nothing, not in combat, it kind of docks, but I don't know, the ship is still out there. So this is the M.A.C.O. variant. Really nice pattern on the hull. And next, the new Kara space set. Always fun to see this vessel turn into this. Some really, really nice details on the hull. Also on the nacelles, you kind of see it like, you know, right here, bluish to yellowish. And that yellow engine wake. And that really nice animation there from the deflector. And just for the fun of it, I'm gonna go to the right. So, new Kara. And then we're going to have the Omega Force. All three types. That's how it looks with the Omega Force space set equipped it. Some really, really nice details all over the hull. I'm liking it. Let's see, what else do we have? We have the Riemann space set. Oh, that's the wrong one. Riemann. And the Riemann. Three sets. And this is how it looks with the Riemann space set. Totally changes the ship. It's now scary looking. It's like, ooh, what is that? Next is going to be the Romulan space set. Where are you? There you go. 1, 2, 3. Romulan. There it is. The Romulan space set. Alrighty, next we're going to have the Solanae space set. Solanae's. Let's see, 1, 2, 3. The Solanae space set, just like the Kobali one, doesn't offer any difference in visualization wise on the ship's hull, I mean. So. Just the normal one, kind of customization that we did on the NPC. So I'm not going to talk about this space set a lot. I'm just going to show it and then just move on to the Breen space set. And that is the last one that we're going to feature for this ship, because basically there aren't any more than that. Those are all the space sets that Cryptic has to offer, and this is the Breen space set on the Odyssey Tactical Cruiser. Tier 5, because it's not the upgraded version. Just the normal one. Really nice on this space set from the Breen faction. Look at that, really nice. Just for the fun of it, I'm going to use the Delta space set. Just because I can. Okay, so those were all of the space set. Now I'm going to go to the bridge. And you guys are in for a treat, because this bridge is one of the best bridges that I have ever seen out there. And as you guys can see, we kind of like transported right onto the bridge. They have their own transporter pad over there. Really nice. They have these big windows over here, so you can basically see outside of the ship. It doesn't, you know, show you any other ships, but it's really nice, you know, to have that, you know, detail over there. Really, really nice. And then you have basically your captain's quarters over here, so you can access your account bank over here, this big locker over there. Access to library files if you want to do any information lookup on all that. Contact duty officers right at this console over there. And I should say some nice, you know, accommodation for you, captain, right? Not bad. Basically, you walk onto the bridge again. There is like this section here where you basically have your pilot or navigation controls, I should say, or I think they are here. Basically, you plot the course here and there, and then you like go. And this beautiful, you know, scenery right there. You know, you can basically look outside and see the stars. Really, really nice, finer details, man. Whoever did this was really, really good. Some basic like holographic consoles over here, the way it should be in Star Trek Online, not pushing buttons. basically two-way, you can go up, you know, the way I went down there. And basically, you know, over here I went to down. So I'm gonna go over here. This big panoramic view again. You know, you can basically see outside what's happening over there. Really, really nice. Yeah, basically come to this part over here where you have like this big view screen. You can see the stars. You have like some other consoles where, you know, bridge officers are doing their thing. And right here you have captain's chair, first officer, and you know, whatever else. Really, really nice. I'm liking this bridge a lot more than all of the other ones. This one is really, really nice. Those finer details, you know, the holographic consoles, really nice. And basically you can have, I don't know, like tactical over here and over here as well doing their thing, or a science officer in this case. Okay, so I am going to go in infected. Where are you, infected? Scrolling down, there we go, normal. And I'm also going to activate combat log. Oh, I want to show the mini version. Not enough time. And In the description below, there is a video tutorial how you can get this DPS overlay for yourself if you are interested. Combat log 1, enter. So basically I'm going to activate all of my weapons to auto fire, and also going to activate that Aquarius destroyer. Set focus so you'll know what's going on. There we go. Gravity well is over there, because you kind of need that one later on. Now, somebody's draining my shield. That's not a nice of you. So I want my shields back. Well, that's nice. Somebody already popped a generator. See, that's why you need gravity well. So you guys can stay there. And then we can do the nanite transformer. Let's activate that one. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to push them back, because we're not done yet. There we go. They destroyed it, so and that's how you do that. Our shields are failing. No, it's not. Let's go emergency power to shields. Where is the sphere that I'm targeting? All the way up there. Now, as I said, this ship doesn't turn really good, but it's doing, you know, not bad on DPS. I mean, I'm at 2,400, and that's for a ship that is, you know, with the basic Mark 10 weapons and no consoles at all. So that's not bad, right? So somebody popped the generators again. Not really nice of them. So we need to put a gravity well on these guys. Come on, come on, come on. Gravity well, stay there. And then we can try to kill the nanite transformer over there before those guys even show up. I think we got him. Yep, we did. Good game, team, because now it's just a mop up. Let's see, I'm at 2000 damage per second that I'm dishing out on this ship. Not bad at all. If you equip some nice consoles on this ship, some fleet weapons, or, you know, Mark 12 or Mark 14 weapons, you can get this ship easily over the 10,000, you know, mark. So Really, really nice. So let's group these guys together. Those spheres with gravity well. So that is the Aquarius pad again. Set focus so we can always see what's going on with that one. Are we done now? Yeah. Let's go for the gate. As you guys can see right now, I'm not doing a lot of damage, but I am, you know, holding my own. Look at that, 2,400. Again, not bad, right? Not bad. Come on, cube, where are you? Oh, there's a sphere over here. Really? Let's call on some pirates to assist us. And that nanite sphere is almost dead, so just a tactical cube left. There we go. How much are we doing now? 2,700. Not bad. Just out of range. There we go. There we go. Put a gravity well over there just because we can. There it is. That's it. Accept the reward. And we did it. We did it. So I hope you guys liked this ship review. I also showed you guys that Aquarius Escort Pet. It's one of these. Actually, each of these variant, the tactical, the engineering, or the science, Odyssey cruisers, they all have like a universal console. So that's, you know, really nice too. If you're having, you know, having about 6,000 Zen, I do recommend this ship. If you are, you know, one of these guys that actually want to have the Odyssey bundle, just get it. It's about 6,000 Zen. So, you know, you can have all three variants of them. And yeah, that concludes this video. This was the Odyssey Tactical Cruiser, and it was a tier 5 variant. So I hope you guys had a little bit of entertainment out of this video, and if you did, give it a like on YouTube. Guys, thank you for your time.